Hello friends, welcome to Ekida. Title of the lecture is One Line Diagram and Impedance and Reactance Diagram. So, impedance and reactance diagrams are the simplified equivalent circuit of single line, or we can say one line diagrams of power system. So, to analyze power flow and complex power system calculations. See, the real power system calculation become more complex in three-phase system analysis, fault calculation of unbalanced and asymmetrical systems. So, in such cases, the system is represented with single line diagram or this one line diagram. And after single line diagram or one line diagram, then drawing equivalent simplified impedance and reactance diagram to analyze and calculate is an easy way. See, you know what is single line diagram or one line diagram. I have already told you. Single line diagram, or we can say one line diagram. See, in power system, so many components are there, like generator, transformer, transmission lines, and different loads are there. So, if we connect them in a particular way, if we connect these components in a particular way, so we can say single line diagram is nothing but a representation of combination of the various components using their standard symbol. So now we will convert this system into absolute system and per unit system. Absolute system and per unit system. See, representation of power is done by two methods. Representation of power is done by two methods. First method is absolute system and second method is per unit system. So basically we choose per unit system. I'll tell you why. See, we have different components in our power system: generator, transformer, transmission line, and loads. So, this is the representation of a single line diagram by using their standard symbol. So, we know first power is generated at the generating station. This is star connected. Now, this generated power is step up using step up transformer. Step up transformer. We generated voltage at lower voltage. Then using step up transformer, we step up the voltage and send this power through the transmission lines. Here is bus bar. This is bus bar 1. And this is bus bar 2. Bus 1, bus 2. Now again, bus 3. Now this voltage is stepped down using step down transformer. And again, bus 4. And this power is then delivered to the load. So there are two types of load. Load can be a motor, synchronous motor, or induction motor. So single line diagram is the representation of component using their standard symbol. So for generator, standard symbol is this. For transformer, standard symbol is this. For transmission line, standard symbol is this. And for motor, standard symbol is this. This figure shows the single line diagram. Single line diagram. See, we have already studied in detail the single line diagram in our chapter number 1. So please go through that video. Now, we show single line diagram in two systems. I have already told you that representation of power is done by two methods. First is the absolute system and second one is the per unit system. First, see the representation of actual circuit. Representation of actual circuit. How we actually represent. So first is our generator. It is star connected and this is neutral. So generator is represented like this. This is R. This is reactance. This is resistance. This is synchronous reactance. So representation of generator, we represent our generator like this. This EG is the generated EMF of the generator. This is resistance, suppose RX, and this is synchronous reactance, JXS. This is the actual representation of a generator, and in this representation, if we neglect the resistance part, because generator is lossless generator, so if we neglect the resistance part, this is looks like something, this EG, generated EMF of the generator, resistance is neglected, so only reactance part, this is JX1. So this is for the first component, generator. Now second component is the transformer. Second component is transformer. First component, generator. So transformer, representation of a transformer. See, this is the Z1. This is the primary side of the transformer. This is the secondary side of the transformer, secondary winding, and this is the impedance of the secondary side. This Z1 is the impedance of the primary side and Z2 is the impedance on the secondary side. Voltage across the primary side V1, voltage across the primary side V2, and this is N1 ratio N2. So this is the actual representation of transformer if we neglecting our shunt branch. This N1 ratio N2 is the turns, number of turns. And here is the induced EMF. Now suppose we want to refer all this impedance in primary or secondary side. So how is it looks like? Suppose we refer to primary side, all the impedance in primary side. So this is Z1 plus Z2 dash, this is voltage, this is V1 and this is V2. This is the primary side, and if we refer to secondary side, this is while we neglecting the shunt branch, and if we refer to secondary side, all the impedances on the secondary side, then it is looks like this. All the impedances on the secondary side, Z2 plus Z1 dash, V1, V2. V1 across the primary side, V2 across the secondary side. This you know this. Now, third component is the transmission line. Transmission line. So, this is the impedance of the transmission line. So, transmission line are of two types. First is short transmission line and second one is medium transmission line. Now, fourth one is the motor. First one is the synchronous motor. So, synchronous motor is represented like this. This is the RM, resistance motor. This is reactance part. This is EM. So current IM, this is resistance, this is reactance, JXM. So total R plus JXM is equals to Z M, impedance of the synchronous motor. This is synchronous motor representation. Now, second motor is the induction motor. So, induction motor is represented like this. Induction motor. Suppose we have a stator. So, this is the stator part, primary side on the stator part. This is R1. This is reactance Jx1. This is voltage across the stator. Now, after stator, rotor. So, this is the Jx2. This is resistance. This is R2 by S. See, this is a stator. Stator resistance R1, Jx1. And rotor is short circuited, but we are getting from R, we are getting from resistance, so that's why R2 by S. Now, if we refer this diagram, this representation of induction motor, refer to the primary side, induction motor looks like stator part, this is R1, Jx1, this is Jx2 dash, rotor part, and R2 by S dash. This is the when we refer to the primary side, and voltage across this is V1. So this we can draw it as this is total reactance and total resistance. So this is V1. Total reactance is equals to Jx1 plus X2 dash and total resistance R1 plus R2 dash by S. So, this is Jx1 and R1 is the stator part and X2 dash and R2 dash by S is the rotor part. So, this is how we represent our actual circuit. Now, representation of power system is done by two methods. First one is the absolute method. Absolute method. So we represent components in these two systems. First is the absolute system, and second one is the per unit system. So all the components of the power system like generator, transformer, transmission line, and loads. So we represent all them in a particular way, and that way that representation is known as a single line diagram. When we connect all the components in a particular way. Now, in absolute system, representation of components in absolute system. So, this is the generator part, e.g. I have already told you that how we actually represent our actual components. First, in single line diagram, first is a generator. So power is generated, and then this power is using step up transformer, stepped up. So this is the representation of transformer T1. So Z1, transformer T1 refer to primary side. So this here is we had one bus bar. Now transformer T1. This is the primary windings. Now, after that, we transmit the power through the transmission line. We had another bus bar. This is bus bar 1. This is bus bar 2. Now, we transmit the power through the transmission lines. So, ZL, line impedance. Now, next, we had another bus bar number 3. Then, we had another transformer. Step down transformer where voltage is stepped down. So this is Z1 dash. This is impedance referred to primary side for transformer T2. This is the transformer winding. Then again we have another bus bar number 4. Then we give this power to the load. We have two types of load, synchronous motor. So for synchronous motor, representation is like this. We have impedance ZM, this is EM. Then next load is the induction motor. Induction motor representation is like this: resistance part and the reactance part. Resistance R1 plus R2 dash by S and reactance JX1 plus X2 dash. See representation of induction motor we have just studied. This is the representation of induction motor. JX1 plus X2 dash and R1 plus R2 dash by S, where this JX1 and R1 is the stator part and X2 dash and R2 dash by S is the rotor part. So this is the representation in absolute system, where first power is generated at the generating station, then using the step up transformer this voltage is step up, then through the transmission line this voltage is sent to the another transformer where voltage is step down. And then after this, this is given to the load where power is supplied to the consumers. So there are two types of load: synchronous motor and induction motor. So the drawback of this system, drawback is this: first, in absolute system there is a discontinuity due to the transformer. See, there are discontinuity due to the transformers. First drawback is there is a discontinuity due to the transformer. Second drawback, as we can see in absolute system, voltage level. Suppose at generator side, voltage level is V1. After transformer, it changes to V2. After transformer T1, it changes to V2. Then again due to transformer T2, it changes to V3. You see in this diagram that voltage is generated at a generating station. So here voltage is generated at a generating station. Then this voltage, suppose this is voltage V1, then this voltage is step up using step up transformer T1. So suppose that voltage is V2, again due to transformer T2, this voltage is step down, suppose that voltage is V3. So we will get different voltage levels. So number of equations for the network solution is more, and number of equations is directly proportional to the number of voltage level. So number of equations more, so network solution is more because of number of equations. So time requirement for calculation is high. That's why we never prefer absolute system. Time requirement for calculation is high. That's why we never prefer this absolute system. That's why we prefer per unit system. Now representation in per unit system. So representation of power system in per unit system, there are certain advantages. First, per unit impedance of transformer referred to any side is same. First, I'll draw the diagram. See, first power is generated. So this is the impedance of generator, EG. Now this is the generator side. This we had a bus bar system one. Then we had a transformer. Suppose this the impedance is Z1. Then we had another bus bar. Suppose this is bus bar 1. This is bus bar 2. So power is generated. Then we have a transformer where voltage is step up. Then we have a transmission line. So transmission line impedance Z line. Then this voltage is step down using the step down transformer. Suppose this is Z2. This is transformer number 1. This is transformer number 2. This is the transmission line. Now step down transformer is used to step down the voltage. Then this is given to the load. We have two types of load: synchronous motor and the induction motor. So ZM and EM, this is for the representation of synchronous motor, and induction motor is represented by resistance and reactance. So this is known as resistance of induction motor per unit, and this is reactance of induction motor per unit. This is bus bar number 4. So in this diagram, you have seen that discontinuity is removed in this power unit system. So one main advantage is discontinuity is removed. Another advantage is that per unit impedance of transformer referred to any side is same. Per unit impedance of transformer referred to any side is same. So another thing in this power unit system, that voltage and current level will same. And only one single system is here. Only one single system is there, as there is no discontinuity. Single voltage level will be there. So calculation easy. Because number of equations required has reduced, number of equations required has reduced and is equal to 1 because it is a single line diagram. So this is the advantages of per unit system. That's why we choose per unit system for representation of a power system. Thank you.